Turning now to the controversial push for charter change, prime movers of the People's Initiative not bothered by the signature withdrawal forms released by the Philippine poll body. The group Birma says they even welcome COMELEC's move, adding this will not make a dent in their push to amend the charter.
Hindi naman kami nang babahala. In fact, natutuwa nga kami na kung gusto mag-withdraw ng ibang mag-withdraw, okay lang dahil alam mo, tayo nasa isang demokrasya, may mga pro, may mga anti. Ganun talaga yan eh. Sa politika, meron tayong labanan, meron tayong pagtutuos ng mga boto at mga signatures. Merong mga hindi sasang-ayon, may mga sasang-ayon. Pero in the end, yung nakararami ang mananalo. Kahit na mag-withdraw ang isa sa bawat 10 pumirma, meron pa rin kaming 17% na nalikom na signatures.
The group says so far they've collected the signatures of 19% of the total number of registered voters across the country. This is much higher than the at least 12% required by the law. Philippine prosecutors approved the filing of arson charges against filmmaker Jade Castro and his three companions. The case stems from the burning of a modern jeepney in Catanawan, Quezon Province. The provincial prosecutor's resolution cites Castro's opposition to the government's jeepney modernization program as a possible motive for the crime. But witnesses and a CCTV footage attest to Castro being in the town of Mulanay during the incident. The Philippine government accuses China of using cyanide to deliberately destroy Bajo de Masinloc in the West Philippine Sea. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Katrina Domingo. Kat, good afternoon.
Hi, Rica. Chinese fisherfolk have been using cyanide in Bajo de Masinloc to intentionally destroy the traditional fishing grounds of Filipinos there. That's according to an official from the Bureau of Aquatic Resources, who says that parts of the resource-rich lagoon have been destroyed. According to BIFOR's Chief Information Officer Nazario Briguera, Chinese fishermen have been seen using this illegal substance that kills not only the fish, but also the corals in the area. He says the BIFOR has yet to assess the amount of the damage due to cyanide fishing, but Briguera estimated it to breach the billion peso mark. He says this is a serious concern that the Philippines and other nations need to condemn, as this will not only affect the Filipino fishing ground, but also other marine resources. Brigetta says there are about 385,000 Filipino fisher folks who depend on the West Philippine Sea for their livelihood, and their catch from these grounds amount to around 275,000 metric tons of fish, which is about 6 to 7% of the Philippines' entire fisheries sector. China's use of cyanide, BIFOR says, especially in the area beyond their exclusive economic zone, is a clear case of illegal, unreported, and undocumented fishing. Beijing's latest incursion in the Philippine waters is an attack against humanity that, according to Philippine Coast Guard spokesperson on the West Philippine Sea, Commodore J. Tariela. If we recall, Rica, the Department of Justice earlier said that they are preparing documents and evidence to file a case against China's activities that have compromised the marine environment in the West Philippine Sea. While the case has not yet been filed, the BIFAR has allocated 660 million pesos for the purchase of 66 units of 62-footer fishing vessels this year. Rica.
Hi, Katrina. Just one question, please. Is BIFAR actually having an idea that these Chinese fishing vessels might be Chinese militia masquerading as Chinese fishermen?
No word on that yet, Rica, so far from the BIFAR, but the BIFAR tells us that they have videos showing the Chinese fishermen's alleged use of cyanide in the area, but they said that they will release those footage later on this month. Rica.
All right. Thank you so much, Katrina Domingo, reporting live. The El Nino Task Force assures the public of a stable supply of food with a weather phenomenon expected to peak soon. Our correspondent, Andrea Taguines, is now on the line with that story. Andy, good afternoon.
Hi, Rica. The Philippine government assures the public there is still enough food supply in the country, particularly food for staples such as rice, corn, pork, chicken, and sugar. That's even if some regions are already experiencing damage to agriculture due to El Nino. According to El Nino Task Force spokesperson Joey Villarama, damage to rice and corn crops in Region 6 and 9, that's Western Visayas and Zamboanga Peninsula, are now at 151 million pesos. But Villarama guaranteed that farmers in these areas are being assisted through the distribution of heat-resistant seeds to replace their damaged crops and in terms of irrigation. Villarama also noted that based on the Agriculture Department's latest report, the nationwide supply of rice and other food staples is still sufficient. And for rice specifically, that supply is still sufficient until September. That is why they do not foresee any food price increases for the foreseeable future. But just in case, Villarama said the National Economic and Development Authority, which is also part of the El Nino Task Force, is also prepared to come up with fiscal measures to address possible shortage. They're also considering bringing in more food imports. Meanwhile, Villarama also said that the DOH has yet to monitor any outbreak of diseases due to El Nino. State Weather Bureau Pagasa earlier warned Filipinos of warmer days ahead. Currently, 41 provinces throughout the country are under a state of dry condition, dry spell, and drought. And by April and May, Pagasa projects that the number of affected provinces could rise to 80. Rika?
Thank you so much, Andrea Taguines, reporting live. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa warns the El Nino phenomenon may already be at its peak. Pag-asa says maximum daytime temperatures in northern Luzon could reach over 40 degrees Celsius next month, while residents in Metro Manila could experience 36.5 degrees Celsius daytime temperatures. Pag-asa says this number may further increase due to the heat index. The public is now reminded to hydrate and wear light and protective clothing when going outdoors. 41 provinces across the country are reeling from the effects of the dry spell. Pag-asa projects the number of affected provinces to rise to 80 by April and May. Oil prices are headed higher next week following a slight rollback last week. Estimates show motorists would have to pay at least a peso and 40 centavos more for a liter of gasoline on Tuesday. Diesel prices also set to go up by at least 90 centavos. As for kerosene, its price per liter may increase by as much as a peso and 20 centavos. The Philippine Energy Department earlier said the price increase could be attributed to the intensification of the Middle East conflict, disruption of shipping in the Red Sea, and the surge in the stockpile of U.S. crude. The Philippine Food and Drug Administration set to speed up the review and approval of generic drugs. That move was welcomed by a doctor's group, but they cautioned that should not compromise the quality of the medicine's evaluation. Vivian Gulia has more.
Many consumers prefer buying cheaper generic medicines because their branded counterpart costs nearly double. But not all branded medicines have a low-cost alternative.
Gaya niyan, o di may pambili pa akong bigas. Maganda naman po yung generic. Basta inumin mo lang kung ano yung binibigay ng doktor, kung ilang piraso, basta itama mo lang doon sa resita niya. Gumagaling po. Kasi subok ko na po yan.
Kadalasan, kapag may nagsasabi, ang mahal kasi nito, ganito, ganyan. So, ang recommended namin, balik ka sa doktor mo, pa-check up ka, then mag-ask ka kung ano yung pwedeng pang-palit doon sa branded na niresenta sa'yo.
As more people seek the generic version of prescribed drugs, the Food and Drug Administration vows to expedite the review and approval of generic drugs to 45 days from the current 120 days. On Thursday, FDA Director General Samuel Zacate signed the circular that expands the coverage of the facilitated registration pathways for drug products to also cover generic drug registration applications. Under the circular, the expedited process may be availed for generic drugs that have been approved by at least one reference drug regulatory agency, a regulatory authority considered by the World Health Organization to apply stringent standards for quality, safety, and efficacy in its process of regulatory review of drugs and vaccines for marketing authorization.
Meron po kaming listahan ng mga countries that we consider RDRA. Ang category po na hindi kami nag-determine is the World Health Organization. Okay. Ang importante lang po yung produkto approved po ng isang RDRA, strict regulatory agency. Mm-mm. Pagpasok po dito, mag-a-apply po sila at bibigyan nila yung documents na in-evaluate na po ng kanilang originating RDRA. Yun po ititignan namin. At yun na po ang magiging reliance namin. Hindi na namin uulitin yung proseso. Kaya po siya ganun kabilis. 45 days.
The Philippine Medical Association welcomes the development, provided the generic counterparts undergo thorough studies prior to approval. Philippine College of Physicians President Dr. Ronjin Solante also commends FDA's move, saying it will improve access to low-cost yet effective generic drugs. He, however, says the expedited process should not compromise the evaluation on the efficacy and quality of generic drugs. The FDA circular is expected to take effect in less than a month. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
As the Philippines remains vulnerable to calamities, a group has created a multi-hazard platform where Filipinos can report disasters in real time using their mobile phones. Rafael Bosano has the details.
During inclement weather, one of the most difficult things is getting around. And who else can better describe this challenge than motorcycle taxi drivers like Jen, who are out on the street every single day?
Magre-rely lang po kami dun sa passenger kung familiar siya dun sa area. Na sabi niya, kuya, mataas yung baha dyan, lipat na lang, reroute na lang tayo. Minsan pagkaya naman, susuungin yung baha kung hanggang saan kaya ng motor.
She says it would greatly help if there's a way for them to learn of hazards like flooding beforehand so that they can carefully plan their route. Using some social media platforms, it is now possible to report floods, earthquakes, and volcanic eruptions through mapakalamidad.ph. Those behind mapakalamidad.ph says it's important that reports of hazards come directly from those affected.
Sino pinaka mabilis na makaka-responda dun sa report na iyon kundi yung mga tao mismo na nakakaranas nung disaster na iyon. Yung taong nakakaranas mismo ng baha, pwede nilang sabihin na hanggang tuhod dito, hanggang Bewang, hindi makadaan yung kotse kasi nakikita nila na may nasiraan ng kotse doon. So ito yung mga bagay na pwede nilang picturean, pwede nilang i-describe, at pwede nilang ipin yung lokasyon kung saan mismo nangyayari yung baha na iyon.
Reporting hazards through Mapakalamidad is simple. So say an earthquake happened and you wanted to show the damages sustained by this building. Using Facebook and Telegram, all you have to do is follow instructions on giving out several pieces of information as well as a photo. And several seconds later, your report is now on the website of mapakalamidad.ph.
We collaborate with OCD, the national government, local governments, to validate the reports made on the platform.
Evidente says Mapakalamidad aims to work with national and local governments to help the public improve the way they report different types of hazards. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
The death toll from the massive landslide at a mining site in the southern Philippine province of Davao de Oro climbs to 96. Rescuers continue to search for the 18 people who remain missing more than a week after the tragedy occurred. The local government has assured the relatives of the victims of continuous support.
10 days no after the incident, andito pa rin po tayo sa ground zero. We started the search and retrieval operations last February 14. Pero i-reiterate ko lang po, i-clarify ko lang po na even though we have switched from the search and retrieval na po, we still do it. Our search and rescue, SAR teams natin, ang ating operations doon, we still do it with utmost caution. The difference lang po is our primary objective right now is to really retrieve bodies and to give them back to their families.